In this video, we are going to talk about voltage and resistance. So let us begin our discussion with circuit and current. A circuit can be a closed circuit when it is complete and forms a loop that allows the current to flow through it. This figure shows a simple circuit consisting of two components, a battery and a lamp. The circuit allows the current to flow from the battery to the lamp, through the lamp, and then back to the battery. Thus, the circuit forms a complete loop. Electric current can be defined as the continuous flow of electrons in an electric circuit. The conducting material consists of a large number of free electrons that move from one atom to another freely. When we connect the battery to a conductor, the electrons started moving from the negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery, while the direction of the conventional current is from the positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery. Now let us learn about electric potential. The capability of the charged body to do work is called electric potential. When a body is charged, either the electric electrons are provided to it or they are removed from it. The work done is stored in the body in the form of electric potential. By moving the charges either by attraction or by repulsion, the charged body can do work. The electrical potential is determined by the capacity of the charged body to do work. The greater the capacity of the charged body to do work, the greater is its electric potential. So we can say that work done to bring the charge from infinity to a point x is called as electric potential at x. Now let us learn how to measure the electric potential. The measure of the electric potential is the work done to charge a body to 1 coulomb. Electric potential is equal to work done by charge. The work is measured in joules and charge is measured in coulombs. So the unit of the electric potential will be joules per coulomb or volt. So we can say that if W is equal to 1 joule and the charge value is equal to 1 coulomb, then we get a value of 1 volt for the electric potential. So for example, if a body has an electric potential of 10 volt, which means that 10 joules of work has been done to charge the body to 1 coulomb. So what is potential difference or voltage? The electric potential difference is defined as the amount of work done to carry a unit charge from one point to another in an electric field. Some work or energy transfer is required for the electron in a conductor to move in a particular direction. This work is performed by an external electromotive force, that is EMF. So we can say that voltage is defined as the difference in the electric potential of two charged bodies. If two bodies have different electric potential, a potential difference exists between the bodies. For example, consider two bodies X and Y have potential of 7 volt and 5 volt. When these two bodies are joined through a conductor, then the electron will flow from body Y to body X, as body Y is having lower electric potential, while the conventional current will flow in the opposite direction from X to Y, that is from high voltage to low voltage. The flow of current stops when the two bodies attain the same potential. So we can say that the current flow in a circuit only if a potential difference occurs. No potential difference, then no current flow. As the unit of electric potential is volt, the unit of voltage will also be volt. Now let us go through the difference between the electromotive force and potential difference or voltage. The potential difference and the electromotive force both is a form of energy. One major difference between the EMF and voltage is that EMF is caused by converting the other form of energy into electrical energy, whereas in voltage, the electrical energy is converted into other forms of energy. So we can say that EMF is the potential difference between the terminals of the cell when no current flows, while voltage is the potential difference between the terminals of a cell when the current flows through it. From the table mentioned here, we can see the differences between the EMF and voltage. So EMF is the amount of energy supplied by the source to the charge, while voltage is the energy required to move the unit charge from one point to another. EMF is measured between the end points of the source when no current flows through it, while voltage is measured between any two points of the closed circuit. EMF is generated by the electrochemical cells, solar cells, batteries, etc., while voltage is caused by the electric and magnetic fields. The unit of both EMF and voltage is volt. Now let us discuss about the potential rise and potential drop. From the figure, we can see a circuit with a cell and a resistor. Here the cell is an energy source that will provide a potential difference of 1.5 volt. So there will be a rise in a potential related to the cell. So the cell's potential difference is denoted as EMF. The resistor is also linked with the potential difference. As it is a consumer of energy, there will be a drop in the potential across the resistor. We can relate the potential rise or drop with the terms of voltage. That is, we can see the potential difference across a cell as voltage rise and the potential difference across a resistor as a voltage drop. So what do you mean by resistance? It is the opposition to the current. Current is the flow of free electrons, while resistance is the opposition offered by the substance to the flow of free electrons. This opposition happens because atoms and molecules of the substance obstruct the flow of these electrons. Some substances like silver, copper, etc. offer very little opposition to the flow of electric current, and so we call these as conductors, while some substances offer high opposition to the flow of electric current. So we call it as insulators, example glass, rubber, mica, etc. The free electrons start flowing when the voltage is applied across the resistor. These moving electrons collide with each other and it opposes the flow of electrons. The opposition of electron is known as resistance. The heat is generated when the atom or molecules are colliding with each other. The unit of resistance is ohm. Now let us discuss about the factors upon which the resistance depends. The resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to its length. It is inversely proportional to the area of the section. It also depends upon the temperature and the nature of the material. So we can say that R is proportional to L by A, or which is equal to R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is a constant. It is called as resistivity or specific resistance of the material. Specific resistance or resistivity. The resistivity can be defined as the ability of a conductor or the material to oppose the electric current. The unit of resistivity will depend upon the unit of the area of cross-section and length. So from the equation R is equal to rho L by A, we can say rho is equal to RA by L. So if the length is measured in centimeter and the area of cross-section in centimeter square, the unit of resistivity will be ohm centimeter. And if the length is measured in meters and the area of cross-section in meter square, the unit of resistivity will be ohm meter. Another term related to the resistance is conductance and conductivity. The reciprocal of resistance of a conductor is called as conductance, which is represented by G. Resistance is the opposition to the current flow while conductance of a conductor is the inducement to current flow. G is equal to 1 by R, where R is the resistance. The SI unit of conductance is Siemens, denoted by the symbol S. Conductivity is the reciprocal of resistivity of a conductor. It is denoted by the symbol sigma. So, conductivity is 1 by resistivity. As sigma is equal to 1 by rho, we can replace the equation G as A by rho L, which is equal to sigma A by L. The SI unit of conductivity is Siemens meter raised to minus 1. Thank you for watching the video. For more details, please visit our website or mail to us.